Neutralite has the best startup in the entire kit. It's great to use for engaging, especially with dash. It has pretty decent range too, so you can now prioritize weapons like sword, katars, and gauntlets with it. It also has the most active frames out of all the cannon's light attacks, so it's the best move to use when catching enemies out of a dodge, which oddly enough happens a lot after you use a Neutralite. So you can do Neutralite, wait for forward dodge into Neutralite, or you can chase dodge forward if you expect them to dodge backwards, then use Neutralite. It's overall a very flexible move and relatively safe against shorter range weapons, so look to use it a lot if the enemy doesn't have too much range. Satellite is a move that is very situational. Its startup isn't great. It has okay active frames and high recovery. The high recovery alone should already tell you not to use this move too often. One way to use it is to engage with dash on enemies who are constantly floating a bit off the ground backwards. Not too high, just barely off the ground. This is pretty risky though, since you move yourself below them and they just have to avoid it to punish you very easily. The other common way is to just punish bad dodges, like when the enemy dodges right above you and you see it coming. And lastly, you can just use its mobility to bait people by just using Satellite backwards for seemingly no reason. When you do this, the opponent will usually try to punish you because most people react to the start of attacks and not after, because if they did wait to see which direction you're attacking in, then it's probably too late to punish. So usually, if they see you do an attack, they'll assume you either be moving forward or standing in place and hit those places. But when you Satellite backwards, you're moving away from that area, and after they try to punish you where you actually aren't, then you can punish them for missing. Obviously, the more you do this, the less they fall for it, but that's also a good thing, because if they don't try to punish every move you do, then you can do real engages which might hit because they won't dodge since they think it's fake. Downlight is amazing for punishing. It reaches a good distance. You can true combo it into neutral air or downer for some great damage. It's not good for anything else though. The hitbox isn't all that great. It's got really slow startup for a light attack, and you basically beg to be punished by dolphin diving forward while the enemy is in full parry mode. They just have to jump or dash backward forward to punish you for it. So what you want to do is use jumps and dashes to force them to miss an attack, and then you can use downlight to punish them. A common thing that happens is when they jump up, I would use dash right below them and then backdash. A lot of players get trigger happy when they see you dash forward and throw out something, so you just immediately backdash and then downlight to catch them. This works best when they jump because they can't dash while jumping, and the worst they can do to you is jump again, so you can't punish them, but then you're not hurt, so it doesn't really matter. Neutral air is a fairly weak move in my opinion. It's basically gun neutral air but slower. Less hitbox, way higher startup, recovery frames, and active frames. The only upside is that the cannon neutral air can actually kill. It has one of the highest recovery times in the game, which is very punishable. So if you were to play by ignoring that the move even existed, then that's not too bad of an idea. But of course, if the enemy starts noticing that you're never using it and keeps floating right above you, then you can use it, but otherwise I wouldn't really bother with it. Side air is a really simple move. You move in a straight line, so it's good for just reach mostly. It looks like it would be good for punishing, but it has 14 startup frames, so it's a bit slow to wind up and it has very little range. The only way I really use this is when I'm really close to the enemy and think they jump or fall into it. Then I side air because even if it misses, then it moves far away from them, so it's hard to punish that way. If you use this move at far range to attack the enemy, then again, you're usually asking to be punished. Fortunately, it has the lowest recovery on cannon, even lower than grounded light attack recoveries, which is normally lower. This means that the time to punish this move is very low, so you can basically use it a lot at close range and will rarely be punished for it. Using it in a bad position can still be bad though, so think about the range while you're using this move. And of course, because it moves forward horizontally, you can use it to help you get back to stage a bit after being hit out. It's not as good as Lion's Side Air or Gauntlet Side Air, though for this scenario because it propels you downward more than those moves, but it still helps a little bit. Downer is a very situational move. It has the highest overall frames on Canon, meaning its longest move. So it's one of the easier ones to punish as well as see coming. And to add on to that, it has very little range, so it's very hard to engage with this one. The best thing about this move is that it's got a wide hitbox and hits diagonally downwards, so you can come in from the air to punish missed attacks. So similar to the downlight, you have to bait out the enemy attacks with movement before using this to punish. The recovery is very similar to the bow recovery, and unfortunately, it also suffers from what Nutriar suffers. It has higher startup, high recovery, and a bit smaller hitbox than the bow recovery does. So it's a lot easier to avoid than the bow recovery. This move is pretty straightforward. Whenever the enemy is really high and diagonal from you, you can use it. Something a lot of people notice though, is that it can't hit too close to the user. So as long as the enemy doesn't jump too high, you can't just jump into recovery to hit them. But a little trick you can do is to jump, then fast fall a little into recovery. This catches the enemy off guard a lot because they think it won't hit so low, but it does when you fast fall a little before using it. Canon Ground Pound is one of the slower ones and has a hilariously small hitbox during the time to hold it, but once you release it, then it explodes similar to the way the blasters work, but once again the hitbox is merely a shadow of the blaster's Ground Pound hitboxes. But it does have one thing it's better at, which is that it lasts longer and the hitboxes is taller even though it's more narrow. So the best way to use Ground Pound would be to pretty much predict when the enemy will jump into it, then release at that position and let the lingering active frames hit the enemy downwards. When trying to learn a weapon, it's important to know which moves to use a lot and which moves are situational, so here's a list of the moves and how often they should be used. Start by getting used to the better moves first, then move on to the more situational and harder ones to use. I hope this tutorial helps you play Canon better. Leave a like and subscribe if it's helpful. Thanks for watching and have fun on Canon.